Belly fat can be stubborn to lose, and there's actually a reason for this. The type of fat that we store in our midsection is different than the fat we store elsewhere. It's called visceral fat, and it builds up when certain hormones are high, as opposed to subcutaneous fat, which builds up when we consume excess energy overall, aka we eat more food than we need. Now, because of this, we can actually reduce visceral fat by making certain tweaks to our diet and lifestyle without reducing calories. And we're gonna go over 10 ways to do this in today's video. Now, I just wanna say that you don't have to do all 10 of these. You can apply as few or as many as you want. Of course, the more you can do, the better results you're gonna get. But if you can only implement one or two, you're still gonna see results. The first one is to cut pop out of your diet. Fructose, which is the main type of sugar that's found in pop, is more likely to be stored as visceral fat, whereas glucose is more likely to be stored as subcutaneous. This is because fructose has to be processed by the liver, whereas glucose does not need to be processed by the liver. And one of the top, if not the top source of fructose in our diets is sugar-sweetened beverages, including pop. These drinks allow us to consume massive amounts of fructose that we wouldn't be able to consume from whole food sources such as fruit. So if you can cut the pop out of your diet, you're gonna see reductions in your visceral fat pretty quickly. The second thing you can do is to be smart about carbs. Now, I talk about being smart about carbs all the time on my channel, and yes, reducing carbohydrates overall can be an effective strategy for reducing visceral fat, but as long as you're being smart about them, you don't need to cut them out entirely. The reason that being smart about carbs or reducing them can be so impactful for our visceral fat is because carbohydrates are the macronutrient that stimulates insulin the most. You might remember that at the start of this video, I mentioned that visceral fat is caused by certain hormones being high, and one of those hormones is insulin. When insulin levels are high, this causes insulin resistance in our bodies, and fat is more likely to be stored as visceral fat. So anything we can do to lower our insulin levels and keep them low for as long as possible is going to help to reduce visceral fat. And this is where being smart about carbs comes in, because depending on how you eat carbohydrates, more or less insulin will be needed. For example, if you eat carbohydrates in isolation, if you eat just a banana on its own, which doesn't have really any protein or fat in it, all of the carbohydrates are broken down in sugar. This causes your blood sugar to go up, and as a result, a lot of insulin is needed all at once. But if you pair that same food, that banana, with a source of protein and fat, so for this example, let's say some peanut butter, it takes longer for the carbohydrates to be broken down, digestion is slowed down, there's less of a spike in blood sugar, and less insulin is needed. I have other videos on how to be smart about carbs, so I will link one up above if you're looking for some more tips. The third thing you can do is to take apple cider vinegar before your meals. Vinegar in general has been shown to improve our cells' sensitivity to insulin. It lets our cells take in more glucose, and again, less insulin will be needed all at once. All you have to do is add 1 tablespoon to a glass of water and drink that before you eat. And I love this tip because it is so easy to apply and it's inexpensive. Quick side note, because I know I'm gonna get asked, gummies and apple cider vinegar pills, avoid them. The gummies, first off, are loaded with sugar, which takes away from the benefits. And the capsules have been shown to be not as effective as the liquid. They do help a little bit, so if that's all you have, then go for it. But like I said, the liquid is gonna be best. The fourth thing you can do is prioritize sleep. And this might be the most important step. You can be doing everything else right, but if you aren't getting proper sleep and if your body isn't recovering properly, then your insulin levels are gonna be high and your cortisol levels are gonna be high, both of which contribute to the buildup of visceral fat. And these hormones will be elevated after just one night of poor sleep. So if you are getting inconsistent sleep on a regular basis, you can only imagine the impact that this is gonna have. It is so important to have a consistent sleep schedule. You wanna be going to bed at roughly the same time every night and waking up at the same time every morning within about a 1 hour window. Always give yourself at least 8 hours of sleep opportunity. And as soon as you can in the morning, try to get outside and get some sunlight exposure. This helps to sync your circadian rhythm, and it starts a timer for when melatonin, the sleep hormone, is gonna be released later that night. Another thing you can do if you are on your devices, on your phone, if you're watching TV in the evening, is to wear a pair of blue light blocking glasses, because light exposure in the evening after sunset, this can trick our bodies into thinking it's still daytime. This can cause our cortisol levels and other hormones that energize us to be released at a time when they should be lowering, which can obviously make it difficult to fall asleep and stay asleep. So pop on a pair of blue light blocking glasses. I really like the ones from Bond Charge. They've been lab tested. I have had the same pair for probably 5-6 years. I wear them every single night. Put these on after sunset, go about your evening, try to have a little bit of a wind down routine, and you're gonna sleep like a baby. Step number 5 is to supplement inositol. Inositol is a naturally occurring substance that's found in foods such as citrus fruit, but the human body can also make it. Because the body can make it, it's considered to be a non-essential nutrient. However, a lot of people, for various reasons that I won't get too much into today, their bodies aren't efficient at creating it. And supplementing it has been shown to have a lot of benefits, particularly for improving insulin sensitivity, which again can help to lower insulin levels and reduce visceral fat. I really like the one from So Well Health. It's called Get So Synced. It combines 2 types of inositol with vitamin D and folate as well. It's fantastic. I'll put a link to it in the description box down below if you're looking for one. This one is specifically formulated for women. I'll link to some of my favorite brands for men and women in the description box down below. Number 6 is to skip a meal. Basically, this is another way to say try intermittent fasting. When we're not eating, this is when our insulin levels are lowest. And this doesn't mean that fasting for longer periods of time is necessarily better. You still want to be eating enough for your needs, but skipping a meal here and there will help your insulin levels to drop, and this will help your body to improve your insulin sensitivity. And it doesn't even have to be skipping a meal. Just push your breakfast forward a couple of hours, have your dinner a little bit earlier, and then your fasting window overnight is gonna be longer. Even if you can fast for just 12 hours a day, stop eating at 7 p.m., don't eat again until 7 a.m., that's gonna have a big impact on your visceral fat. If you can make your fasting window a little bit longer, maybe 14, maybe 16 hours, even better. But that's probably the sweet spot for daily intermittent fasting. If you can do that, you're gonna see huge improvements in your visceral fat. Number 7 is to run fast. And this is an interesting one. And I know, not everyone is gonna be able to apply this, but hear me out, I had to mention it just because it is so impactful. Sprinting triggers the body to release high levels of a specific group of hormones which drive the release of visceral fat. And you get these benefits from exercising at your maximum capacity for a short duration of time, usually 15 to maybe 30 seconds. Then you're gonna rest and repeat. If you can do 1 sprint session a week, this is also known as high intensity interval training, 1 session a week, that will have a big impact. If you are doing these workouts any more often than that, some people I know try to do HIIT workouts 3-4 times a week, that is completely counterproductive. Like I said, you get the benefits when you can perform maximum efforts. And if you're not giving your body enough time to recover in between these workouts, then you're not gonna be able to hit your maximum. Again, if sprinting is not something you are currently able to do, that's totally fine. Apply the other tips, skip over this one, but it has been shown to have a big impact, so I had to mention it. Number 8 is to reduce alcohol. Visceral fat is highly associated with excess alcohol consumption. Like fructose, alcohol has to be processed by the liver, and excess consumption can lead to more visceral fat buildup. There is a pretty clear relationship between alcohol consumption and the size of our waistlines. I think people subconsciously or on some level know this because this type of fat buildup is often referred to as a beer belly. And therefore, cutting down your alcohol consumption, again, you don't have to cut it out entirely. If you don't want to, that's for you to decide. But it is a big driver for visceral fat. So reducing it where you can, that's gonna help a lot. Number 9 is to quit smoking. And I know, most people know that this is not good for you. But again, I had to mention it here because there is a relationship between smoking and with the size of our waistlines, once again. And this just goes to show that it's not all about calories. 2 people can be eating the exact same thing, exercising in the exact same way, but if one of them is a smoker, they're going to have more visceral fat. And finally, number 10 is to increase stearic acid. If we swap certain types of fat in our diet, this can actually reduce visceral fat. And the type of fat we're swapping in and out might surprise you. Stearic acid is a type of saturated fat that's been associated with fat loss and specifically visceral fat loss. So much so that it is sometimes isolated into a supplement. We can find stearic acid in animal fats that we use for cooking, such as tallow, ghee, and butter, and also in some fatty plant foods, such as cacao butter. So swapping your cooking oil from a vegetable oil to one that's higher in stearic acid, again, tallow, ghee, butter, all great choices. This can help to boost your stearic acid intake and in turn reduce visceral fat. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. Let me know in the comments which of these steps you're going to try first. Are you already doing any of them? Have you noticed a difference? Let me know down below, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.